I wonder at times if we are really listening for the wind of the Spirit. What would that power of God's Spirit, what would those tongues of fire mean for us as a people gathered here this evening? We hear in Scripture that the power of the Spirit is dynamic, enlivening, and creative, not static. The Blessed Mother came to understand that, and what that meant when the angel Gabriel said to her, "The power of the Most High will overshadow you." The disciples came to understand that, the implications of that, when Jesus said, "You will receive power and you will be able to be my witnesses throughout this world." Today we hear that the apostles, behind closed, locked doors, hearing the Spirit like a mighty wind, feeling and knowing and seeing the very tongues of fire, the power of the Spirit, inflaming their hearts. That word power means to be able. Our task as God's people is to be able. To be able to experience God's Spirit in love. Not the division, the lack of understanding, the world confusion that many times results because of the Tower of Babel and the towers of Babel erected throughout the world today. No matter what the date, the place, the language, the Spirit gives shape to who we are, giving us a new heart so that we can say yes, so that we can say, yes, we are able. And that is good news, and that is why we gather here. But are we really ready, any one of us, for the unexpected? The bad news is that no one is coming to fix our wounded world for us. Our readings remind us that we can't remain locked like the disciples in the rooms of our own ideas and ways of doing things, at times being rigid guardians of the status quo. The problem is that God's Spirit is in fact disruptive, disturbing, dangerous, and world-changing. Can we be pushed beyond our imaginations? Can we overturn the divisions of Babel, refocusing our hearts and our lives and our minds, setting our hearts free, walking together as God's people on the face of this earth, working together as God's people on the face of this earth, and loving each other on the face of this earth as God's people? The power of the Spirit is given to us, to you and to me. And it's like a current of grace, our Holy Father says, running through us. In fact, it is given to all of God's images, the Spirit. All heard in the Gospel, or all heard in the Acts of the Apostles, the sound of the Spirit and the feeling of the Spirit, all felt that power that they were able, and no one group owned it. A clique is not a community. So our greatest task as God's people is to be able to link the power of this world and the power of the Spirit, knowing that we are able as the body of Christ to heal the wounds that tear at our common humanity and to create so much, at times, human suffering. This suffering can occur in our own homes, at Santa Fe High School, at Sandy Hook, at Parkland, or years ago at Columbine, just as it can happen in Syria, or Yemen, or France, or London, or on 14th and St. Elmo here in Canton. The regeneration of God's people says we are able to meet the challenges of today. We at Christ the Servant have the strength. We at Christ the Servant have the courage. We at Christ the Servant are able. And that is a mission that is given and shared by every single one of us because of our baptism. And so we pray tonight as we gather here as God's people. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and ignite the fire of your love. And through that power of that love, we beg you, Lord, to help us to renew the face of this earth. God bless you.